Up where they prime. Up where they stay all day in the sun. Wandering free. Wandering free. Wish I could be part of your world. And cut. What's up, Goofy Goofy YouTubers? It's me, and I'm back with another freaking video. I know y'all miss me. And listen, I really been trying to get y'all some content, but I refuse to put out BS content. Also, I'm not going to sit here and lie to you guys and act like I've been really trying to put out content. But I have, but I haven't. Oh my gosh, I forgot this toothpaste is on my face. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. So if you guys are wondering why I even had toothpaste on my face, because I have that giant freaking pimple right there and I want it gone. So I was trying to dry it out, even though people say you shouldn't do that because it leaves a scar.
I said, fuck it.
So I've been trying to like vlog and stuff because you guys know that I've been traveling a lot, but every time I get to vlogging, I forget that I was supposed to vlog that day. And then like, I always vlog the boring parts. Like, how do you, somebody tell me, how do you capture the magnificent parts? Because stuff with me just happen randomly. Like, it just be happening. I'd be like, God dang it, I should have vlogged. But yeah, so I have like kind of like a vlog from Miami. If you guys want to kind of see that, I didn't get any meaty footage basically. Like, I mean, y'all see me walking around the beach and going to the beach and meeting people and stuff like that. But I didn't get any like meaty footage. So on my channel now, what we're going to be doing is doing paintings of the week also. And the painting of this week is Keisha and Gucci Mane, the Wobsters.
Hey, handsome.
Yeah. Me.
Yeah, you, who else? I mean, you're so silly.
They
call me Gucci,
I just they got
pajamas on. One more thing before we get into this video. If you guys like this jacket that I have on now, as you guys know from my previous videos, or maybe you don't, maybe you do, but I have a clothing line, which is available now, and my website is up. This is a hoodie, of course, and it comes with sweatpants to match, but I just didn't feel like putting on pants.
Yeah, I don't got no pants on.
In unacceptable condition. Unacceptable.
No, for real though, y'all. They are available for purchase. I'm also about to set it up where you can just buy a jacket if you want to, or just buy some sweatpants if you want to. Like, you don't have to buy the whole set. Right now on my website, you have to buy the whole set, but I'm gonna try to like separate them because some sets don't. Some hoodies don't have the matching jogging pants, so I can only sell them separately. But y'all get what I'm saying? My website will be right here. I'm gonna put it right here. So go check that out. I also put the link in the bio in my description, so it'll be easy for you guys. So before we get into this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope this is very, very helpful for you.
Because it's helpful for me, huh? Oh, I missed you guys.
So from the title of this video, you guys should know that this video is tips and tricks for artists and young entrepreneurs. I'm still trying to figure out my like little situation, my business, and I'll be going through mad anxiety, but I can give you guys tips since you guys on my YouTube and on my Instagram think that I must know it all. Bitch, I don't. But I will tell you guys the things that I did and the little tips that I did so I could be a full-time artist at the age of 20. Yes! I actually became a full-time artist like at the end of like my 19 year, but like my whole 20s, I decided to be a whole, like, not my whole 20s, but my whole 20. I decided to be a full-time artist. I really could not deal with the 9-to-5s-ish. Like, I really could not do the 9-to-5. Like, it really was not me. It was stressing me out. And also, I'm a person, I like to help people and make people smile. And I like to, like, you know, like, I like people to remember me, you know, in a positive light. And I feel like I wasn't getting any positivity or really impacting anybody's lives by telling them where the hell the milk was or if they wanted chicken in their Chipotle bowl. Like, girl, I couldn't do it. So I decided to become a full-time artist. Woo! Number one, you really don't need a lot of money.
Mind blown! Hi, Britney! Mind eaten!
Like, honestly, when I quit my job, I didn't have money. Like, I think I had $100 from my last check, and I spent $20 of it because I had to get a lift home. Honestly, it's really just about your craft and pushing it. Like, this is so big for artists. Like, a lot of artists don't understand. A lot of celebrities that I didn't like did paintings of and got in contact with, stuff like that. You gotta be resilient. You gotta be entertaining. You gotta have personality, and your art has to stand out. You cannot just post it one time and then get discouraged because the person didn't see it or the person that you painted of or whatever didn't say nothing about it. You gotta keep pushing. Y'all know how many people I kept fucking tagging? I kept tagging them. Like, I was like, on it. Like, if you got a DM them, post it on your page, have people tag them, post it on your story with a little funny caption and at them. Like, you just have to be on it, period, point blank. As an entrepreneur, it's very, very, very important for you to go harder for yourself. Nobody is going to go harder, give you any handouts. With a 9-to-5, it's like you have stability. You know when you're going to get paid. You know how much upfront, all that. When you're becoming a full-time artist, all of that is on you. It's really on you. How much money you have a day is on you. How many people you impact is on you. How many clients you get is on you. Because at the end of the day, it's 8 billion people in the world. 8 billion plus people in the world. Just because the little 10, 20, 30, 40 around you, or like your little 100, 200, 2,000 followers reciprocate or they don't appreciate your work does not mean that somebody else in the 8 billion people is not going to see your work and appreciate it. And you never know, one of those 8 billion plus people might have $1 million to spare to throw at you for your tiny ass art that you was discouraged about. You have to stay resilient. You have to push through. You have to apply yourself. You have to apply yourself. That's the biggest thing. You cannot get nowhere. Nowhere if you apply yourself. Do you not know? Even with all my skill, all my talent, all my creative thoughts and my process, I still wouldn't be nowhere. I would be broke and I would not be sitting here talking to y'all, because it still takes work regardless. Talent is only a part of it. Everything works together as one big whole, you know? You get what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm trying to throw at you? Number two, think of ways to improve yourself. Think of ways to expand your brand. Think of other outlets. Not everybody is going to want a canvas painting. Not everybody is going to want a paper painting. Not everybody is going to want a drawing. Oh, like, yo, this is about to be the motherfucking phrase today. And this is 8 billion people. I don't know about y'all, but I'm trying to get all the monies. I'm trying to reach all the people. I'm trying to get all of this. I don't just want a little section. I don't want a little piece of this, piece of that. I want it all. So since I want it all and I want my impact to reach out, I'm gonna put what I've been working on into the fashion world. I'm gonna put what I've been working on into the animation world. I'm gonna put what I've been working on into all these different venues. So it's like, I'm not just a gallery artist. I'm also a designer. I'm also a writer. I'm also this, that, and the third. Like, you'll have to sit there and think, like, what can I do to expand my brand so I can be a mogul? When people be like, oh, you're a portrait artist, what type of artist are you? Girl, I'm just an artist. Like, girl, I'm just talented. Like, you see that? That's realistic. That's portraits. You see the background? That's abstract. You see this? This caricature. This is a caricature. You just need to, like, see other ways and figure out other ways to, like, adapt to your environment, adapt to your situation, and push it. Push it, son. Push it. Number three, remember that there is no turning back. Once you decide that you're wanna move forward in your art career and you don't wanna live this 9-to-5, you feel like you don't wanna keep doing that, there's no going back. I'm sorry. There's no going back. You have to push. You have to push because you know the feeling that you get when you at your 9-to-5 and you already feel like it's not the place for you. If you quit that 9-to-5, go do your art stuff, it's not working out at that time that you feel like it should work out, and then you backtrack to your 9-to-5, you're gonna feel way, way, way horrible. You're not gonna want your fan base to see you, you know, make it seem like you struggling or you gave up or you quit. It's like, bitch, no, bitch. No, baby. When I quit that job and told you I was never coming back again, I meant that. Regardless, if you're not in a good area, make a website. Get on social media. Reach out to bigger people, bigger artists. Ask them questions. Nah. With that, it's been a lot of like older artists that like I reached out to and asked, and they didn't give me no love. They didn't show me no love. So with that being said, y'all can hit me up. Cause y'all know I always shout out artists. Like I always help artists out because I was there once. Like, you know. But remember that there is no turning back in this art game. And you have to have the drive that, oh, I don't got $100 right now. I'm going to make it. Like, I'm going to make this money regardless. Like, I'm going to sell this painting regardless. I'm going to do this, that, and the third. Number four, when dealing with pricing, I have a bad problem with this too. And I'm really trying to like tell myself this too, because when I do pricing and stuff, I be like on the fence because I don't ever want to overcharge, but I don't want to undercharge myself, you know? But at the end of the day, you gotta say a price and stick with it, period. You gotta stick with that price and always go for the price that you feel like you're worth. Regardless if I did this painting, Akeisha and Gucci, I say it's $15,000. They hit me up like, oh, well, we'll give you $5,000. Regardless if the person that you made it for feels like it should be that price, it doesn't matter. If they're not trying to pay you what you feel like you should be paid, then scrap it. Sell it to somebody else. Sell it to somebody who's gonna appreciate it. If you feel like it's too tailored to them, make it into you so you can sell it as your art. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I had to do. I was tailoring my paintings of celebrities and stuff to that celebrity. And then it was like, when that celebrity didn't wanna buy it, it's like, well, bitch, who gonna wanna buy a whole big ass painting of you? Like, come on. So you gotta tailor it where it incorporates the person that you trying to draw to you, but also you can flip it into something else. You know, so it's not a waste of time. Number five, do not be afraid to put your money and invest your money into your business, into your company, into your life. If you only got $500 and you go and you need $300 worth of canvases and supplies, put that into your business. Invest into your business. Invest into your brand. If you too scared to invest into your brand, nobody else will invest into it. You do not know how much money I just spent Y'all, I be freaking myself out. Like, bro, you could have had like $15,000 by now. But I always put back into my brand. I always go, when I get paid from clients, I literally go to the art store and I buy like $500 worth of art supplies. Easily. You can literally make times two, times three, times four of what you just put into your business. Period. It's just, all you gotta do is flip your money. Like, that's all you gotta do. It goes back to having confidence in yourself. Like, you gotta have confidence and drive. You have to be like, yeah, I'm putting this $300 in, but I know I'm about to make 800. I know I'm about to make 1,000. I know I'm about to make this back and some. You know? Number six, make a website. Cause a lot of people be asking me, do I have a website? I do have a website, but setting it up and stuff just been very, very irritating. Honestly, I might just pay somebody this week to finish it because I just really want to be an artist. Like, I like being a businessman. I like being a socialite, this, that, and the third. But when it comes to like directly emailing people back, that's stressing me out. When it goes to making websites, editing videos for y'all, like all that, I'm like, oh, damn that. It'd be stressing me out. And then my calendar, like all the scheduling, all that. So if you are willing to be a great assistant, no Selena.
Selena was meeting Saldivar to recover missing financial papers when Saldivar allegedly shot.
No Selena. If you are willing to be a great assistant, please email me. I'll put my email in the description. Email me because I need assistance. It's getting too chaotic. All the clients, all the prices, the inquiring, all that. I can't. If you're good at web design, if you're good with working with Shopify, please email me too. Because listen. I need some help. Some milk. All that. Some bread. I got turkey meat. Ain't got no bread. I can't make no sandwich. But none of that depends on y'all. So I don't really want this video to be like mad long. I do have some more points, tips, and tricks, but I can say that for another video. If y'all like this video, please contact me via Instagram, DM. Also, comment on this video and like, thumbs up. Thumbs up, T-Fo. And if you guys like the merch, if y'all messing with the merch, it comes in Burgundy, black, white, tan, ivory green. I feel like I'm missing a color, but it's okay. Gray, I don't think I said gray. If y'all are messing with the merch, be sure to click that link in the bio in the description to get you some ugly culture. Run it up! Run it up! Yo, but no, for real. And if you do order, please take dope A pictures and tag me in them so I can repost you and put you on my page because I love the support. I love when the people support me. I support you. Oh, also, a discount code for your next purchase for 30% off your whole purchase. So, see what I did there? Without further ado, Goofy Goober YouTubers, thanks for being patient with me. And thank you for watching this video. Now, I gotta finish some more jackets for some clients and some more painters, so further ado, I'm out of here, girl. Bye, girl. Babu!